First of all, hats off to Longwood. They're a very solid program. We play them, you know, every year in a doubleheader, and you know, they're always competitive. They started out slow and got better as the season went along, and I knew that they would be competitive, you know, coming into this weekend. So, hats off to them. I thought today, you know, we didn't, you know, we kind of spotted them three runs, and then when I say spotted them, I mean they certainly did their part in earning them, but you know, giving up three early, and then the way we finally came back, made adjustments that we've been needing to make really for a couple of days, and you know, being able to come back and have a chance to win it. I was proud of the girls for not giving up and sticking with it.
Questions for student athletes? Kelsey, you know, as I said, you fell behind 4-0, but you had the big inning and to tie it up. What kind of changed that inning? What helped everyone start, you know, swing the basketball in that inning?
In our team meeting before that inning, we all just wanted to have fun. So we all went up there loose. Katie started off with a big hit. I followed it with a big hit. And it's kind of that old saying, you just pass the bats along, and hits are contagious, and that's what happened to the beginning, and it was a just different feel from all of us.
Maggie, you came in there in relief and struck out a lot of batters. What was working for you today in the circle?
I felt like I was throwing pretty hard, and I had solid defense behind me. They were making all their plays, and just went out there with some confidence and didn't hold anything back.
What changed for you there in the last inning? Did they make some adjustments on you? Did you throwing as hard or anything different there in the last inning?
They're a good offensive team. They're going to make adjustments, and they did.
Obviously, you know, you guys made the NCAA tournament, but you know, you guys aren't used to going 0-2 in these things. Is it make it a little wince a little bit, I guess, or how tough is it to go away from the regional without winning a game?
I mean, it hurts. We expect a lot out of ourselves, and I think we making this regional was a big thing, but we weren't here just to play. We weren't just happy to make it, so it hurts to, you know, come out. But overall, we're a strong team. We had a great season overall. Our seniors had a phenomenal career, and we just had fun. We played the sport that we love.
Kelsey, obviously, you had a couple good hits today, but you know, that one inning was it for you guys in terms of putting runs on the board. What made you know, from just talking to your teammates, because you know, what made it a challenge to hit against Longwood today?
I think we adjusted well the second time through the order, as you can see with Katie and me and Jay Fern with that big walk, and Bailey with the double, and Gaskell to get her in and all that. They put in a new pitcher, and that was a slight adjustment for us, and it usually takes us about a round through to get adjusted, at least through this second half of the season, and I think that kind of blanked us a little bit. It wasn't that we were missing or anything. We were hitting them hard, just right at them at the end there.
How was that reliever, different kind of pitcher to face from the starter?
I only saw two pitches off her, but she seemed a little bit quicker. She seemed a little bit faster.
Maggie, how much when you come in the game in the first inning like that, you're down 3-0. You know, how much pressure are you feeling there, knowing, you know, I can't, you know, I've got to get us out of this, and then I really can't give up too much more here to keep us in this game.
I mean, I wouldn't call it pressure. I was just going out and trying to do my job. Kelly's had my back multiple times over the season, and it was just my turn to have hers.
What was challenging with that Longwood hitting attack?
Well, you know, I think, you know, in Kelly's case, you know, when she came up, she was hanging a lot of pitches up. You know, she was staying up in the zone. She wasn't able to get the good pitches down. And, you know, we tried to get through the order there. We had, you know, it's like Maggie said, they've kind of piggybacked off of each other, you know, a lot. And we just got to the point where it's like, you know, we can't, you know, taking more risk, you know, and get down any further, and I thought Maggie came in and did a great job, and you know, Maggie's been getting more strikeouts as a whole than Kelly anyway, so she came in and did her job. Obviously, 11 Ks, and that's a pretty good outing.
You guys lost 10 of your last 11 games. You guys start out the season so hot. Can you put your finger on what kind of change were this last batch of games, or where wins were so hard to come by?
I think when we got a few of those first 10 losses and near the end of the season here, everybody just tried to do too much in the plate. And just as a whole, every single person just tried to win it off one swing of the bat instead of just putting it all together. And I know we struggled a little bit pitching here and there. It was just, it seemed as if we had all kind of were trying too hard to make something happen out of just a little bit, all at the same time.
I mean, I think the beauty in it is that that was the end of our season, so we can refocus going into next year and let that go.
You guys lose four seniors in the lineup there, but obviously you guys, you know, your pitchers are back and you do a bunch of hitters back. What is your assessment of how good this team could be going forward?
There's a lot we can learn off the end of the season, but we do have our returning pitching staff. We have Chelsea Whitcomb coming back in too. Michaela was a freshman this year. She's seen how the college ball is and everything, and she'll do well. We have a lot of good hitters returning, and we have a few good ones coming in. I know Lauren Duff and a few other ones I've heard a lot of good things about. I think as upperclassmen, we got to take them under our wing and show them how everything can go, how to train properly and things like that, and we can just have another run in it to make supers and farther next year in an ACC championship.
Is losing to a Longwood and having them be the ones to eliminate you as opposed to a Tennessee or a Utah, does that make it harder, I guess? Or
Everyone who made this regional, I think, deserves to be here, and that proves it. The four seed can beat the one seed. It's the sport of the game, you know, anyone can beat anybody. And they came out and played their best, and we fought, but it just wasn't enough today.
Any more questions for student athletes?
Thank you.
All right, guys.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm.
Scott, what do you feel in terms of having to do? It was just that one inning where you got to put some runs on the board. What made it so difficult today?
As far as I think what she was saying, you know, we kept on popping the ball up. We were trying to, as Coach Miller said, we were trying to hit three-run homers with nobody on base. You can't do that. You know, you got to settle in. You know, we got them to buy into trying to, swing a good pitches, but see the top half of the ball, try to square it up a little bit versus trying to dip and rip, you know, the ball over the fence, you know. And once we kind of bought into that, I thought we did pretty well. I mean, we even had hit the ball well there then. You know, Gus hit that one out to left field. It was a nice piece of hitting. I thought Kylie hit the ball hard right back at the pitcher there at the end. You know, I mean, so, you know, it's I thought we did a pretty good job of making adjustments after that and didn't try to, you know, trying to – and then even in doing so and squaring it up, we hit a couple home runs in the middle of that too.
Did you see anything different with Maggie pitching that last inning, I guess, when she gave up the runs? Or?
Not really. They're just tough, you know. And we got the one hit probably was tough was when I guess it was the – I think it was a 2-2 or 3 – it was a 2-2 count on the Sweeney kid, I think. And we just didn't want to fall behind there, you know. And then she put a good swing on, I think, a screwball or whatever, and that kind of got them started there. Put runners on second and third, and it was close play at third. You know, had almost had a chance at that one. And you know, once you get to that and you spot put a couple runners on, and with, you know, no outs, and we almost got out of it. I think the ball that scored the two runs, I thought we had a good shot at catching that one. And I think Lauren thought she was a little bit too, you know, closer to the fence than the ball was closer to the fence than it really was. I thought it was catchable. It would have been a tough catch, but I think it could have been catchable. So, you know, I mean, we pitched out of that with the exception of not catching that ball. So, you know.
What do you think helped you guys in the fourth inning, you know, kind of get back in the game there? What changed for you in that inning?
In the fourth,
when you got the four runs.
When you start out two home runs, that really helps. Kind of gets a little bit of people some confidence, you know.
Did you figure her out, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it's like I said, you know, and even I called a timeout with Bailey before she got the hit that scored. Just Mayor, I was like, you know, just see the top half of the ball. It's just about making adjustments, not trying to do too much, not dropping under the ball. So it's a little bit trying to do too much, like they said, I think sometimes happens. But they made adjustment, squared it up a little bit, and, you know, we had a big inning.
Was Kelly just missing her spot there in the first inning, or was it?
Yeah, everything was up. Even she struck out the kid, and the ball was up. She was leaving everything up, and tried to get through the lineup there, but just didn't work out.
You've never gone 0-2 in a regional before. Is it how weird is it to be the one, you know, leaving here first?
Yeah, it's not too fun, but it's a lot better being here and losing two than being at the house and not playing at all. You know, so the way we finished, you know, this year, and as tough as it was, you know, as far as trying to replace, you know, I mean, when we played as an example, I was just looking back at our stats when we played Longwood, you know, in the first game we run ruled them, and Brianna was 4-for-4 starting in center field. Well, Brianna wasn't starting in center field, and she you know, she's on one leg, you know, and, you know, those types of things. Our kids had to fight through some of that stuff. We had to change up some stuff. But, yeah, I'm glad that we're playing this weekend, you know, and we got that opportunity even though we didn't finish very well.
The more you get away from 2008, is that, you know, when you won this regional, you know, does that show, underscore just how damn hard it is to win a regional? I mean, you know,
it's tough, you know, and I think, you know, I think if you, you know, look at, you've been to our place, and we're getting ready to build some things, you know, and we're getting ready to build a new indoor hitting facility. I think it's going to be huge for our training and just from a recruiting standpoint. We don't have this, you know, right now, but we're going to, and we're excited about that. And I think those are going to be the things that helps propel us from a recruiting standpoint and a training standpoint that, you know, kind of gives us opportunities to feel like we're bringing in the kids, and we're getting some really good kids in anyway. But making that happen so, you know, we can, you know, push ourselves. But it's tough. And you got to get the right regional. You got to get to, you know, there's a lot to it, you know. Good matchups, you know. And I didn't think this was too bad of a matchup for us, although I thought Tennessee had been playing really well this weekend. I think they were the team to beat all the way, for sure. But I didn't think the matchups were too bad for us. Utah had been really playing well late in the year, too. But we just weren't as strong and you know, down the stretch, and we were kind of trying to put it all together here at one time, and we, you know, didn't quite make it happen.
Were you missing something from that hot 22-3 start, or was it just more of a function of schedule, I guess? When you look at how good that team was early on, was it who you were playing, or was there something about the team you were doing certain things better than you were later on?
Well, I think when you have injuries, kids try to step up and try to do too much. So from that standpoint, if we had a fault, that's probably what we did. You know, we tried to do too much and just weren't as successful at times. But if you take that away from us, I'm telling you, if I think if we'd have stayed healthy, I don't think you'd have seen us fall the way we did have the rough stretch at the end, you know. And
You lose four senior starters, but we have back. How do you feel about the prospects for next year?
I feel good about it. I mean, we've got, you know, obviously Chelsea Whitcomb will be back in the lineup. Then we've got some really good kids coming in the freshman class. We're excited about them. You know, when you lose a Kylie McGoldrick and a Lauren Gaskell, two people that have been really strong leaders all the way through for 4 years, you know, those are tough to replace. But when you see a kid like a Chelsea Whitcomb sitting on the sideline, you get excited about her, and then you're excited about some of the kids we're having coming in. So, you know, you're talking about the same pitching staff that got us here, plus who was our number, the kid that was our number one coming out of the fall. So that's positive for us. We're excited about next year and where the future of the program is.
Thank you.